Hey guys, welcome back to some more Horizon Zero Dawn. It's been a while since I played this game. I've been making some other videos.
You're very close now.
I was wondering when you'd speak up.
There's a sheer rock wall just ahead. Look close and you'll find handholds leading up.
Oh really? And who put those there, hmm?
Probably you, Silence.
Wait, why would I expect an answer? It's so much more exciting to keep it all a mystery.
It is!
Eclipse Focus Network, he said. So how are we gonna do that?
I guess...
I forgot. We won't. I do all the dangerous stuff. You just listen in.
Wow, okay. Getting a bit salty there, Aloy. Anyway, I've been playing some other games and doing some other videos recently. But we're gonna get back in and we're gonna finish this game.
There are the handholds. What we said they'd be. Did you get that, Silence? No? Fitting name you got there.
Oh my god. This dialogue is funny. Yesterday I went fishing and I got a pretty decent sunburn.
What now?
You wait, that's what. Take a seat at the campfire and rest. When night falls, we'll talk.
Do they still have a fire to keep me company?
Oh boy, more sitting and waiting. Anyway, I got a pretty bad sunburn yesterday. And do we have a choice here? We can sit at the fire or we can go in. Let's wait for Silence. So anyway, I was saying it's kind of hard to move because of the sunburn, so I've got to stay still relatively. Hello.
How nice of you to finally drop by.
Our purpose this night is to crash the Focus Network.
Yeah, tell me the part I don't know. How?
For starters, you'll need to infiltrate the Eclipse's main base.
Wait, what?
That's right. Fortunately for you, I brought you around to the back way. It's right through that crevice. Once you reach the base, you'll see the objective. A derelict tall neck that's been extensively modified. Climb the tall neck. Grafted into the top of its disc, you'll find a module of sorts. Destroy that, and the Focus Network will crash.
So you were part of the Eclipse?
I've never been part of anything. I serve my own interests, always. But it is the case that I assisted the Eclipse before I sensed the threat they might become. It was a mistake that I'm doing what I can to correct.
What sort of assistance did you give them?
And how can we trust you?
We have more important things to do than ask questions.
Is he the one who helped them find us? Aloy's mad. Sorry, I was talking in fragments again. I wonder if he's the one who helped them find Dr. Sobek, which eventually led them, of course, to us.
More like soldiers. Held in reserve for what to come. You'll have to get past them.
This is the easy way in?
The back way in. I didn't say it'd be easy.
Good point. Come here. Come here. Man, this is spooky back in here. So I had a feeling that Silence helped the Eclipse before, or was at least part of them before, because of the fact that he knows so much about them. And you are not going down without a fight. And we've alerted all the other machines. Great! So we know he assisted them somehow. I'm willing to bet it has something to do with why they attacked us. And that's why he remains silent when talking about it. What the fuck? What are you doing? I was trying to do a critical strike, but I guess not. Oh, come on. Just want to hit you. Stop moving. There we go. I keep missing, and I can't craft more of those because I don't have more wire. So I guess it's going to be fire from now on. And we'll just burn them to death. Ooh, crap. Not good. There we go. They're done. I don't even really need to loot them. I've already got pretty much everything I need. There's another machine up here. What were they saying? I was talking about Silence and how I kind of figured he'd help the Eclipse because he knew so much. I just wonder what he did to help them. There's going to be some major trust issues between us and him. I can already tell because he says that he serves his own purpose. So who's to say that he is not using us to achieve his own goal? And he'll just betray us or drop us off when we're no longer necessary. Oh, god damn it. Oh, god! Get up. Get up, Aloy. And we can't get back up that way. Really? Come on. You can do it. Yes! Yes, we got it. Okay. Good. Holy crap. There we go. Perfect. Now, onward and upward. Over the tree stump. Assuming we can climb up here. Yes, we can. I love this parkour system. So good. Okay.
Explosions in the distance.
Pay that no mind. It doesn't concern you.
I think it does, if it could harm me. We have corrupted scrappers. Great. Come here. Come here, buddy. That's it. You can walk faster than that. There we go. It's your break time. No wires. This is the easiest way to do this. Just sit in the bushes and call them over. The only hard part is waiting it out, because they walk so slow. Oh, by the way, I'm wearing a hat because I'm having a pretty bad hair day. So I just stole Delson's hat. You know, no big deal. He'll get over it. Alright. And the last one is over here. I think this is the corpse of a Deathbringer. It is. That's spooky. Good night, buddy. You're done. I'm glad that thing is already dead. I would hate to see what a corrupted Deathbringer looks like. Oh, god, that would be terrible. That would be terrible to fight. And there's more. Great.
The tall neck's just over this ridge. You'll see it when you reach the top. Now be ready to act fast. You need to get in and get it done before they raise an alarm.
Great.
Here we go.
No turning back. Wow.
You getting this? I see the legs of a tall neck down there, but no tall neck.
Damn. The transmitter has been moved. Check down the ravine to the left. Only place it could be.
So much for your insider knowledge. Toward the explosions. Great.
You got exactly one shot at this, Aloy, so spare the sarcasm and make it count. You see that bridge over the ravine?
Yep.
Memorize its location. There's a rappel point on the side. That'll be your way out.
And these Eclipse troopers?
Avoid them or kill them, your choice. The blasting should cover any noise you make. Find the tall neck and destroy the module on top.
Here we go.
Okay.
It's been weeks since Helis was around. What's he been up to?
So, Helis has been gone for a while. Like that guard just said, we can kill these guys or avoid them. I think we're gonna kill them because they would do the same to us. And then we're gonna head towards the explosions and see what is up. Ooh, that was neat. And the blasting noises should protect us. Okay, is there somebody up here? Oh, yes. Yes, there is. Surprise! Oh, right in the butt! Oh! Oh, that went right through his crotch! Ow! Fuck. There we go. Okay, we've got the hardpoint arrows. Good.
Don't let her run.
You're done. Ooh. Crap, one of those explodey thingies. Good. Not too difficult.
Is there fighting up ahead?
No. It's a mining operation. So long as you're quick, it won't affect you.
Oh good, another secret.
Quick, okay. What is this?
What is this place?
A distraction.
There are several data points.
Ooh, collectibles. Oh my god, look at the collectibles in here. Okay. Woo! Wife.
When sleep refuses to come, I think of our wedding night. How you welcomed me to the marital bed. How after, when you fell asleep, I lay there watching your delicate face. For all its beauty, I detested its fragility. A rage swelled up inside me. I abhorred that bed, how its softness threatened to swallow us up. And that room, the stench of incense, the fine embroidery of the drapes, all of it weak. I slipped from the bed, threw open the casement, and lay naked on the stone floor, determined to spurn all seductions of comfort. But when I woke the next morning, you lay beside me, naked as I in the cold. Your body, stretched beside mine, seemed chiseled from stone. I saw you wake, instantly alert, like an animal ready to strike. You said nothing. You did not have to. Already you had shown me beyond doubt that we were meant to be.
Okay. So he detests comfort because it's weak. And he thought his wife was going to be weak, but no, she's a tough girl. Without pity.
Never does the sun show pity. When my wife died in birthing, and in dying into the life of my child unborn, I pitied myself. My lord sensed this, but instead of casting me down for weakness, he cast upon me a radiant beam of honor. He ordered my kin buried in the sacred caves reserved for royals and heroes. Unimaginable. Never again would I doubt that I am the chosen of the sun. Never again would pity find a place in me. Not for myself or another.
She died in childbirth. And it apparently his child died too. Damn, son. No pun intended, of course, you know.
When I first set eyes on the buried shadow, I trembled. Was I not the chosen of the sun? A blazing light of faith to shred and scatter darkness? Was it not my place to destroy this devil? But High Priest Bahavas instructed me in the prophecy and set right my frame of mind.
murder of the true Sun King broke the cosmic cycle short of completion. The whole world cast into darkness, doomed. To resume and turn the wheel of time would require more than sun and faith. All forces must combine, all halves of nature join to one cause. Shadow to sun, night to day. Even a buried shadow wants the wheel to turn. For without a sun in the sky, there can be no shadow.
Okay, that was kind of metaphorical a lot, but I get what he's saying. So he was chosen of the sun, or at least he believed he was, and somehow he was converted.
My lord, the 13th king of the Karsha Sundom was murdered. Cut down by cowards who mistook firm rule for madness. Ever the strong are beset upon by the weak. So he said, as the traitors launch their assault, as their cannons forged by Osaram filth topple the battlements and burst the gates. I would have fought to the end, but it was his will, the will of the sun, that I lead the prince and queen into the west, to safety. My lord did not hesitate. He saw his fate. He looked into the sun, and he did not blink. With me, he sent kestrels, nobles, sun priests, and slaves. Killing all that stood in the way, I carved a path to sunfall. There, we joined others to gather the strength to take back our home. But our strength only faded until the buried shadow was brought to light.
The buried shadow. I'm guessing since the machines are buried, something from the old world is the buried shadow. Possibly Hades. This is getting very good. That must be his Shadow Karja armor. That looks like it.
So long as King Itamen languishes at sunfall, coddled by his mother, he will never learn the true lessons of the sun. I have tried to instruct him, but the shadow of his mother's influence is upon him. I took him to the palace balcony to behold an offering of sacrifice in the ring, but he showed no thirst for it. He averted his gaze. Look to the sun, I told him. Do not shield your eyes. In all things, it is absolute.
Wanna go blind, pal?
One day, it nurtures life, and the next scorches life away. It burns the skin of champions and wretches alike. Never does the sun show pity. That is the example a Sun King must follow. The example of your father. But before my instruction could take hold, she was there, clutching him to her robes, burying his face against her breast. How is a king to rule when he cannot even see?
I don't know. That's a good question. Ceremonial armor. At least we know what it is. Oh, can I climb here? Oh, I can push it over. Nice.
He's a fanatic, all right. Single-minded.
He is.
It gives him a focus that you seem to lack. Now, how about finding that Tallneck?
It would not have been easy to drag a Tallneck down this path. Why bother?
Just find it and get to the top. Destroy the module, and then get out fast as you can.
Sure is a lot of blasting up there. Sounds busy.
Busy enough not to notice you, let's hope.
I hope so, because
some kind of structure around it.
Climb it. The sooner this is done, the better.
I don't like this. Feels wrong.
Everything here is raw. Just get to the module and destroy it.
Okay, I'm guessing we're not supposed to go that way. So, Helas. He had a wife, and she died in childbirth. And when Sun King Jiran was being murdered, he sent Helas with a convoy of slaves, priests, prince, the queen, away to Sunfall, which is now the Shadow Carja.
I see the module.
Place.
They'll be quick.
This is Hades?
Eloy, this is not the time.
It's a metal devil.
Open the module's casing now. Aloy, do as I say or all is lost.
Okay. Ouch. Oh crap. This is not good.
Entity has come here. Entity miscalculated. Entity cannot destroy me. I am beyond its reach.
Maybe you are, but this isn't!
Ooh. Okay.
Destroy the entity.
Fuck. Come on, grab a ledge or something. You got this. Oh. Come on. You got it. Oh, crap. Go, 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 go. Come on, come on, come on. Move it.
Great trail.
Ah.
Yeah, you think?
I am so confused. Where are we going? Where are we going? Where are we going? Where are we going? Here we go. Move. Move. Oh, grab the ledge. Oh, go, 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 come on. Come on. Ah! Oh, shit. We are getting destroyed. Move it!
Come on.
Don't fight, run.
Oh, there's another Deathbringer. Ho!
Almost out of it.
Almost gone, almost gone.
The whole base is on high alert.
Yeah, I noticed.
Holy shit. Oh god. Here it is. Here it is, here it is. Yes! Shit. At least there was water down there. That was a rush. Need to take a breath. Catch my gears here. Wow. So did we actually destroy it? Because I saw her stab it with a spear, but I don't know if that actually destroyed it.
Rough going, but you survived.
You knew Hades was there and you sent me to him?
I won't deny I risked your life, but it was the only way. Now, with the focus network down, we can both get what we want. Access to the secrets of Zero Dawn.
I'm past trusting you with secrets.
Good. That means you're wising up. Trust is for fools. It shifts and crumbles like sand. A poor foundation for any partnership. But mutual self-interest. Now that is a solid bedrock upon which you and I might build a new science of understanding. We both need answers, Aloy. And thanks to you, we're on the verge of grasping them. It's unfold. We'll speak again.
Damn.
You miserable. Damn him.
He's got some interesting philosophies.
If I could toss this focus and be rid of you, Silence, I... But we both know I need it. Sunfall moved on.
Okay, so he's got some interesting philosophies there. I wonder what kind of a life he has lived in order to think that way. Trust is for fools. Mutual self-interest is a better foundation. There are stalkers over here, and I am not going to get killed by one.